This is a video how to create an animation for an assembly. First step is I run in assembly the degree of freedom animation. I see in this case we have 2 degrees of freedom and I can run it. This is the first and this is the second one. So I close it, and the next is I know this is one object which should be animated and this is the other one, so I create of these objects compounds. I use the animation workbench and it's simple to create a compound. I delete this one. More and this. I only have to select the object and then I say compound create a compound of the selection. And I do the same with the other, create compound of the selection. And what we have seen is that this compound also should contain this part. So what is it? I think this is the part, so I can select this part and the compound and can say compound add selection to the compound, and in this case I have both objects here in this second compound. So the next what I need is a placer for the first compound. For this compound it is here. Oh, I see the manager is running, so I have to stop it. Okay, I need a placer. In the placer I put here a formula for the y coordinate of this blue object. The y coordinate should be 0 at the beginning and then it should grow up to 1550, and the target for the placer is the compound here. Okay, and the second animation I need is a placer which moves the other compound, this one, and in this case into the Z direction. The formula is here. The formula I use, maybe does not make sense, but it's only a demonstration, so I have to say here the target is compound 2. Compound 1. So now I have both components here in the manager, and the next step is that I start the manager and I see first I have the animation of the blue part, and after half of the time the blue part has reached its final position and the brown part will start to move. Okay, now one change has ended and the other change starts. So, and we see here the movement. So we see that we have to do some adjustments still. The blue part has moved a little bit in the Z direction to get a right position. So this is not a problem. I stop the manager. I say the Z part, the blue part, this is this one here. I set the Z value to I think -100. So, and now it's a constant position here. This should be right. I also can change the formula for the Y position, but I do not need it at the moment for the demonstration. So, and when I run again, then I see how it works here. Okay, that's all.